You don't have to. It depends on what the customer wants to do. It might depend on what their policy is about these kinds of things. It's a lot easier to back out if it's all in one package. Okay. There may be other applications for this, but this is the reason that we built it. Okay. That's really all I've got. If you have questions about store or questions about testing at Cincom, feel free.
There has been talk about having a blog server, either on your own machine or somewhere in the middle, which might speed things up even more. So I have preloaded whatever bunches of codes which you can just.
Okay. You're saying like a local store repository?
Yes.
Okay, so that's one thing that I didn't talk about. The store model allows you to have a central server with all developers checking their code into the same repository, or every developer having their own repository, and then we have a replicator. And the replicator will allow you to, on a periodic basis, replicate any versions which are published into one repository to be moved to the other repository. And actually, Cincom does this. We have a Postgres repository and an Oracle repository in Cincinnati, and they exchange all new versions about every 15 minutes. So some of the engineers who, as you may or may not know, work from home, have slower connections, will have a local repository on a machine at their home, and it basically replicates either one way or both ways in the background all the time. And that does solve the problem to some degree of the speed, but it really is a band-aid.
You were mentioning that people could get started by, of course, now using our own use of Warp as a demonstrator. Of course, the absolutely easiest way to get started if you're a complete newbie to Warp, from 7.7, one of the things that you will get in every destination is the store workbook. Just go to the store menu, you'll get store workbook, and it will ask you to which database is this workbook. And then it presents you a number of examples, and it makes one or two easy things for you, like it has a session at one of the store workbook variables, and so on and so forth. So you can literally handcraft a few scripts, see what happens. And it's divided into safe and unsafe. So above a certain point, you've got three, you can't have your database, and below a certain point, there's a very clear warning, okay, this could write to your database. Do this on your local database, not the central server database, the problem we're talking about. And with that caveat, that's a great way to get started even before you look. So it's not a question from the thing. I think that's the way in for people.
Yeah, I just found, Neil, that there just aren't enough examples there.
It merely gives you a
taste. It merely gives you a taste, and then, as Paul said, go to our example of the users that are now actually in the base.
Anybody else?
Is it possible to name a class or method in the study?
Is it possible to name a class or a method?
Keep the history.
Oh, to rename and then keep the history? Yes. We can do that.
Can we change the package?
Excuse me?
Can we change this package and keep the history?
You know, I'm not sure about that. I have to look. Neil? Do you have the answer?
Yeah,
indeed. The answer is yes, but you better know both the Warp and Store Schema quite well. I think that's probably, I anticipate
the tools. The tools aren't going to show you the history.
Yeah.
that way, okay, we can deal with a method that's renamed in the same package, but if you rename it and move it, the tools aren't going to do that for you. The queries in there at this point are not that sophisticated.
You have to write your own query when you better know what you're doing. I anticipate, as Tom was saying, the examples in the store workbook are, they do cover things as complex as that. I anticipate that in 7.9 and in 8.0 and so on, there will be more examples showing how a power user is able to do really, really with almost nothing you can't do. It's just a question of how far you're willing to get. So if you as a customer persuade us that there's a clear customer need for that, you'll probably get a high-level menu that will let us do it. If not, you'll get a script saying, that was a really interesting question, here's the script you run. By the way, you know, do it for the other way. How about
anyone else?
When you plan to change the store repositories, the database structure, will you have a migration plan for all store repositories to be migrated to that?
We won't be doing any major changes to existing tables anytime soon, simply because there are a lot of people who are on versions of store that don't use Store-Glorp at all. But yes, I think that's only fair. That if we're going to change the schema on you, especially if you're using the Office object-relational framework, that we can provide migration as part of that. Sir?
Just on the same point, could you think of, once you have changed the schema, having a backport to up to 5.0, say, okay, if you want to use the new database in version 5.4, take this particular store thing instead of that one which you used to have?
I don't know if you could push it back that far.
Or whatever.
Because there are evolutions to other parts of the product that support this. And you'd have to look at the problem very closely.
It's a question whether it's how far back the demand goes.
Yeah, that's a good question. Neil?
I'm just going to say, hey, there's one thing that is certainly done would be reputation between your client and Apple database. But even if we did need help, we couldn't go back to the point. We could replicate your package and then it would load it from that and you have a miracle.
Okay, well thank you very much for listening. And if you have other questions, please feel free to contact us.